Welcome everybody here to your coverage of the defense. We have fought through months of battles to get right now to our final semi-final. That is right, I said final way too many times during that phrase. We're here for Dignitas going up against AL, so it's the Australians from Down Under. So I put them on the little bottom tab down here, going up against Team Dignitas, the team from Romania. Who will get to come out on top? We will find out in just a couple of moments' time, or maybe a couple of moments, might even be 3 hours if we go to a best of three. We've had some amazing games in the semi-final so far. We might be looking forward to some even better ones right now. AL, they're a team which have actually been a little bit out of form of late. They haven't really been performing in a lot of the big competitions they've been involved in, and that might cause them to have a little bit of troubles in this one. But then again, we do have a couple of weeks break for them between their matches, so they've had time to recuperate, just think about how they're going to approach this game. And they know Dignitas very, very well, and they should be able to come out maybe on top, but at least put up a decent fight if they do not. I'm also going to say I am being joined this evening by Cinderin. He is going to be back in just a couple of moments' time. In fact, I'm just going to spam him to yell at me when he is back. And he will be joining me for this broadcast as well. All right, so we have ourselves our drafting stage. Really weird that Colby decides to ban out Nightstalk, but we're going to go with it nonetheless. Channel Moore standard ban in today's play, and Invoker being banned out straight away there by Woodstock, who is actually a new player for AL. I believe they had a change up in their roster recently. Holy Master can correct me for this one if I am wrong, but I believe Woodstock is actually a new change in. I'm bringing up my little defense roster on my side right now because it's not the exact roster we're used to. Woodstock as well as Bleak are two new names. They might have just changed around their names. That's why I want to double check this. Just before we kick into this, I want to know. I'm a man of information. Animage is banned out as well. It was all really Woodstock could do. You assume that is Snoopy. You assume that is Snoopy. Snoopy is the one that's always been doing the drafts for AL. So you just go with him. And it is Snoopy. So it's Snoopy, Godot, Shaitan, Musica. And it could either be Gods or Risk. And you assume it's going to be Risk, which is Bleak. You jump over to the Dignitas side. Come with me. We've got Coco, Frieza, Zizor, as well as Leon. Most annoying name to have when you have a lion on the side. Prophet's going to be the pickup from Come With Me. Just deciding have the good all-rounder. Bleak is new, Woodstock is Snoopy, and he will rename. Okay, so Bleak is new. That is not actually Risk. Really surprising that that Risk is not playing this evening. His side lane play has always been one of, in my mind, the strongest points of AL. It really allowed them to run, either a dual roam ganking combination and then three solos, because you'd always have that support in the middle lane from the roam, and just be like, you can say that no matter what's going to happen, that side lane is going to function for me because Risk has so much experience with it. But a lot of pressure for Bleak to fill in tonight. And, Snoopy taking a little bit more time than he normally does for the draft, probably realizing, okay, well, we got Prophet. What else they really want to go with? That's something which we're not quite sure from Dignitas. They try new and different things here and there. What are we going to do? We're going to go with our Darkseer. So he is a standard one. We realize in this first game we're playing with a little bit more pink, so that also affects the way, like, what heroes you want to select. You can't go heroes like Pudge, or you want to try and ban any heroes like Pudge because you can't dodge hooks that easily. So we're going to go with a big wall, and we've got easy vacuum, a simple push mechanism, and then we're going to grab up a Raster as well. So Raster, get those wards up level 6 as fast as they possibly can. They'll be going into the hands of Musica more than likely for the solo mid, but has also been mixed up recently as well by AL, where they'd like to run the Shadow Shaman up on the top lane and give him that guaranteed level 6 instead of the possibility of level 6, and then they get ganked. The only downside about doing that is, however, you take the Shadow Shaman out of the middle lane, you can't run the bottle, and things just don't go too well for you after that point. Windrunner comes up for Come With Me. In my mind, still the best side lane solo in the game. Just Eventual Spirits. They might be thinking, you know what, maybe they are going to go for a full team fight and grab that Enigma, so best counter to that is to grab a Vengeful Spirit. Not to mention, she's also a great support hero, so if you want to go ganking, smoke ganking with her, it's a good level 1 stun as well. So if you want to go aggressive very early on in the piece, you can do it with her. And you want it as well. Because that way Prophet can TP in, and it's like, hey, sweet, I don't need to go a Sprat level, all I need to go is just one of my Treants, one of my TP, and I can gank at level 2, because I can guarantee myself that VS is going to land that stun. Crystal Maiden's the pickup from AL. Interesting pickup. Crystal Maiden, one of those heroes which a lot of people do love to watch, but she just doesn't play as much as recent times, mainly because she is just very, very squishy. She can be brought down very, very fast. Like, you have VS, who's a very, very elusive hero. Because you got the swap, because you got the stun, because you got that negative armor, it's intimidation, not to mention the vision you get from that. When you look at a Crystal Maiden, she's got a Nova, and she's got a stun. That's pretty good when it comes to fights for disable, and as well as early aggression. But then your third ability is a passive, is that aura, the mana of everybody on the map. And that helps everybody else out, but doesn't help you. And most CMs will ignore their ultimate just because, like, I can't get that off during a team fight because I die so fast because I am so squishy. I require myself to stand on the rear to stay alive so the mana keeps regenerating, so I can keep on landing my stun, so I can keep on throwing out the Novas, so I can do that burst damage as well as giving that bit of slow. Alright, so we have DK now being banned out.
10 seconds remaining.
It's completely fair enough considering AL have used that combination before. Shaitan does love the DK. Combine him with that Darkseer wall. Get that Agate Interceptor up on Darkseer, of course, and then you start replicating your own team and you have two sets of DKs. Makes it a very, very powerful time. But then again, come with me, could look at Enchantress. I might even still do that depending on what the die want to go for their last hero. And jungling Enchantress would let Prophet sell up on the top, Windrunner. Well, actually, Windrusher solo top, Prophet would have to go in towards the middle then. And then VS carrier on the bottom with an Enchantress. Good work for them. Now we'll have to see if Dignitas want to try and run that. If they want to run that extra jungle, if they want to throw a Prophet in the jungle, if they want to put him on a lane. I'm a big one, like, I know a lot of people who have ever watched my streams or watched me play some horrendous public games. You'll know that generally, I'll take Prophet into the jungle, but as far as competitive play goes, Prophet on a lane is just so much more powerful. You can get so much more fun, you have a chance for a kill at all times, and you can always just change the lanes up. TP yourself down towards another lane, which is about to get a kill, and booyah, you get some levels up, get yourself back up to your old lane. Make sure it's worth it every time you TP, though, that's the only downside. It's all about the decision making. And, well, Syndarin is still taking his sweet-ass time. Nicely done, Sin. And he'll be back in just a moment. There's the Enchantress man from Come With Me. Surprised that he went for that. Enchantress... even then, like, conversions wouldn't really work in my mind. And there's Enigma, so Come With Me is going to take Enigma himself. So they are going to run that either double jungle or that either Prophet or Enigma on a solo. Or on a lane. And Pugna is the ban out from AL, so looking for even more mana-intensive heroes. And that's fair enough, considering the heroes they've got. Shadow Shaman, he drops his entire bank account, and instantly he's dead. And then you've got the Darkseer. He uses a decent amount of mana. OD is not in the tournament build. A question now from Dubzex. OD is not in the tournament build. You do have Klynx. Klynx is available, but will not be appearing in this game. We've commented many, many times how Klynx just does not fit into the current metagame. So he won't be in for this one. But the Dire has two more picks up, sorry. And they're running out of time, though. 9 seconds for Snoopy. He's not really used to being pushed into this, and he's going to go with Pudge. And I was mentioning Pudge before, can be very, very difficult with this ping. But they're going to run him anyway. And what could make this a little bit better for you is the fact that as far as escape mechanisms go, Dignitas don't have a lot. It's not like an AM or a Queen of Pain who can just blink themselves away. And that's how you escape from a Pudge who has a little bit of delay behind him. Because when you go for the hook and you're going to start off with Rot, then go the hook, and then go the Dismember. That's the combination. But there's like that maybe 0.25 of a second normally between when you can hook and you can Dismember. And that 2.25 of a second is basically created to 0.5 of a second when you have delay. And that's something which is very problematic for a Pudge. But there's very little escape mechanisms to come out from Dignitas in this lineup. The only hero I think could do it is actually the Enigma. Because if he has enough time to cast that Malifaux, you can disrupt that ultimate. And that'll be the chance to get away. But if Enigma gets hooked in, more than likely he will be dying very, very shortly after. The rot damage will be more than enough. And Raiden got one more pickup to go. They need someone strong. Someone very, very strong that can do that damage to Pudge or just outlive him. Maybe even a Nakes. Nakes might be an opportunity. For Dignitas, Either that or they have to go for something a little bit more grunty. And they're going to go with tankability, but it's tankability through extra lives and it's Skeleton King. So that's going to give them the damage, that's going to give them that Aang to come back alive again. And that's going to be big when it comes to team fights. But SK's got to be careful, he's going to get replicated by that wall. But, and his illusions are going to deal a crap load of damage to all four of the other heroes. Enigma, VS, Windrunner, and Prophet, they are not strong by any stretch of the imagination. SK has got to put his body on the line there. And when his body turns around against his own team, that ain't going to go down well. One more pickup for the Dire, though. They've got strength, they've got pushing power, they've got the team fight control through the Darkseer Wall. If the Darkseer Wall gets off, that's the only thing which is going down for them right now. The team fight control is based purely around the Darkseer Wall, and they're going to grab Nakes themselves. So they're going to go for the full, I'm going to completely outlast you build. So Nakes also going to give them a jungle option. If they want to run that, they might not run that. I'm just interested to see how we're going to go with our bottom lane. Because as far as the Dire goes, it's going to force them to run their tri-lane on bottom, which means we're probably going to see... Oh, how do we even want to lane this? Because you could run Nakes or Darkseer in jungle, but you still got to deal with that bottom lane. The only other way around it is by running either Nakes or Darkseer in the jungle of the Radiant side, and then you put someone like Pudge and CM down the bottom. That gives Nakes farm on the top lane, Shadow Shaman in the middle lane, and that'll give them the levels they need, as well as enough control on that bottom. But they've got to be careful, because they're going to have SK there, you have Enigma with his stuns, you have VS with his stuns, and then Prophet to TP in at a moment's notice. So there's a lot of problems that could be coming out for AL on that bottom lane. So that's going to be the big, the questioning point for AL, if they will have enough power to deal with that bottom lane. So let's watch our lanes go. Musica is going to be taking the Darkseer. He normally takes his solo mid-roll, but he's going to head down bottom. And he might still go mid. In fact, I got a pretty funny feeling he will. Sorry, we're also getting a little bit of frame rate loss inside the game, which is not too good. Hopefully it doesn't last for too long. Watch this tri-lane. Head down towards the bottom. Snoopy's going to come down as well. So it looks like we're going to see Shadow Shaman play more of a support role with the CM. We've got the entire lineup down here. Snoopy, the player who will normally play up with the Dazzle and just support these lanes up. So now looking out, and they might be able to find out a couple of Dignitas boys just hanging around inside the jungle. So this is their tri-lane, or what they want to run as their tri-lane. But AL are now on the move back, and there was, well, no ward was dropped. There's just a Toidle sitting on that little ward spot. Well, there is a Dire Sentry ward and Observer ward, both stacked on top of each other. Just around next to that creep camp, which is going to stop that from spawning out. Well, let's check out lanes for Dignitas and who's playing who. So Leon as well as Z is going to be playing the middle lane. SK and VS combo there. And then down towards our bottom lane, Freezer taking the role as Windrunner. Up towards top, come with me, is taking the role of Prophet. And we do have Enigma going to go in jungle, and that is Coco. He'll be taking the role of the jungle Enigma. He's just denying that first creep off, so come with me. Has just a little bit more of an advantage on the top lane. And we also see Pudge now pulling that creep.
Hello.
Pudge, hello. Hello, Sid. Welcome back.
Thanks. All right. Yeah, sorry for just
fail.
Jumping in like that.
Fail. You fail. On the bright side, man, the draft is over, the game's just started off, and we're already rolling.
Yeah, I'm glad to see I only missed like half a minute, so Of course you didn't have a companion for the draft, but I guess you survived, so that's all good. Okay, Dignitas on the Radiant and Ale on the Dire. I suppose you have introduced the players for the heroes?
I've just run through the Dignitas side, but we're still going to run through the AL boys.
Oh, I'm going to be all over them then. I'll introduce them, even though they are your friends from down under. We're going to have Snoopy playing as the Shadow Shaman support role. This is something we often see Snoopy do for AL. We've got the secondary support played by Gordot. That's the Crystal Maiden around the middle. Shatan on the hard carry Lifestealer here is also going to be in the middle lane. Pudge by Bleak, who is playing for AL. Mm-hmm. Did he officially join them or he's just standing in?
He's actually an official member now.
Okay.
I had the double checked as we started off. So we have Risk, who is standing out tonight, and Bleak, who is now a member of AL.
Interesting. And then finally, of course, Musica is going to cop it off with Darkseer.
First initial stun, VS follow-up stun, and Nima's going to come in as well. Prophet's going to TP in towards the mid lane, and a first blood in the middle. And Z is going to take a fall as well. Prophet might be able to slow them down. Yes, Shatan will be forced back towards his tier 1 tower. He's got to be careful too. There's another blast in. Actually, no, SK does not have the mana pool for that. Never does early on. But first blood in the middle lane, CM to go down.
Yeah, great start here for Dignitas to get that first blood in the mid. Would have probably hoped to get Nakes as an extra kill there, but Chetan was not possible to bring down at that point. But what I also want to point out about that gang, sure they get the first blood, but they did it with four heroes. Prophet TP'd down from top lane, Enigma went all the way from the woods, and effectively getting one kill for that is not really a fantastic trade-off. It's the first blood, that's why it's worth it. But they're using a lot of time and a lot of resources on this kill. And it set back Prophet completely on the top lane from that. He's not looking good now.
Looks like middle lane might also be having a little bit of trouble. Leon's trying to get himself away. Vius lands off the stun, just pulling CM out of the lineup. One last right click is not going to do the job. And Prophet's going to TP in. Another turnaround. CM goes down. And Chetan be forced back to the tower again. This time there's no sound to get him back on the front lines. But come with me, unable to finish off Chetan again. And you are right. Bleak is going to get a little bit more farm up. They get a kill on CM. Well, that's great. But Pudge gets time to farm. And that's dangerous.
And I'm interested in seeing how the bottom lane is going right now. Frieza versus Musica. Actually, they're fighting right now. Musica taking a lot of damage to, bringing a lot of damage to Frieza, who wants to take the fight. Oh, this one is going to be really close, but Frieza does land the power shot and gives them a 3-0 here.
Yeah, that was really close as far as the farm, fight would go for Musica. It's like positioning. You saw the power shot start to line up and instantly try to go right, but that line just—it was wide enough to get the hit. Surprised that Musica is on the bottom lane. This is not something which normally happens for him. It was something I was discussing very early on, how these lanes would go. And I was actually predicting for AEL to run a tri-lane on bottom so they could deal with this bottom lane where you would have assumed SK probably would have been. But they picked the dual lane going in the middle. And because of that, Windrunner headed down towards the bottom, so it became a Windrunner versus Darkseer lane.
Yeah, and this one is really good for Windrunner at the moment. Got the first kill on the lane. She's 15 for 8. Musica is 11 for nil, so not getting a single deny on the Darkseer. And that's a significant level advantage for Windrunner here. She's ahead by more than a whole level now after that kill. And the only thing Frieza needs to be careful to now is not overextend. If he gives a kill back, Musica is totally on par with him once more.
Mm-hmm. By the way, man, we might just have to restart the Skype call as well because you're cracking like a person. Yeah, I might just restart that one because it came from you to start with. It looks like our bottom lane will be fine. Sindarin, stop that. I'll actually give him a call, so we'll just decline that one and just start it from my end because my net capability is a little bit higher than his.
Hopefully it's better now. Am I good?
Yeah, it'll start to settle itself down in just a moment, but you're at least not going half robot on me, which is good.
It happens every now and then on Skype calls for some reason.
Mm. It's just like a bit of a crackle sound coming through. I'm like, what the hell is that? Yeah, but you sound better now. All right, so still 3-0. How are we actually going with farm, though? Like, it's only maybe 300-400 gold. The difference, 5 minutes in. So it's not as though Dignitas, with those three kills, have got, like, a massive advantage. It must mean that top lane's working pretty hard for AL.
Yeah, obviously, Come With Me is not getting much on the top of his profit. He's 2-0, though, because of those great kills in the middle, and that kind of makes up for his lack of farm. But Bleak, gonna land that hook and go straight in for Come With Me, and there's no way out of this one. Can't land a Sprout, and that's a great hook right there. Giving them the first kill for AL.
It's surprising he manages to land these hooks. They're not the easiest thing to do when we're playing on a USD East server.
Bleak is a very, very good Pudge, so I wouldn't expect less from him. It's his trademark hero. There's a reason AL picked it. I was like, why did AL pick Pudge? We never see AL picking Pudge. And then I saw who was playing. I was like, okay, that's why. Mm-hmm. So Bleak is known to be one of the best Pudge players in the world. And I really hope he shines in this game because it's a pleasure to watch.
Best Pudge players in the world. That's a big claim, man. A lot of people will still go with Dendy for that one. You actually want to give a little bit of history on this guy?
He's one of the best. I didn't say he's the best. but he's a really good player. And the thing about it is I don't know much about him. I really don't. I believe he's an American player, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong on that as well, though.
That would explain why they would throw him on Pudge. As far as ping-wise goes, that's a crap load better for him.
He's got a lot better ping than all the other players in the game, so I'm expecting him to be... Yeah, he must be American or something along those lines, at least. Mm. But yeah, he hasn't really made a big splash anywhere. I think he might have been a good competitive Hun player at some point, not sure about it. But he never really played for any top team, but whenever he played in those American tournaments, from what I've heard is he's a really good player. And, well, that just means it's a matter of time before he
makes a breakthrough if he wants to.
Hang on, there's a kill in middle lane, but it's now down towards the bottom lane where Freeze is trying to retreat back out again. Gonna try and land a shackle, but Musica comes down, vacuums him back in again. The Windrun might be enough speed to get away. CM's last right click will not be enough. And Windrun only just managed to survive. There was a bit of a ring-a-ring of Rosie around the trees, and even Musica surging Snoopy at one point so he wasn't discovered by the creep wave. So Bleakest Canadian is the call from Holy Master, at least. Yeah, but we saw a surge coming out there from Darksteer just to ensure that the Shadow Shaman wasn't seen going down towards the bottom lane. And it's US West. Okay, so it's US West, so AL. AL has the advantage a little bit in this.
Yeah, the second game is going to be on East, though, as Holy Master says, and then we might have a coin toss for the third or something like that.
No, we go back to West for the third.
Okay.
That was part of the rules where we started off.
All right, yeah. Surprised to see in that bottom kill, though, that didn't happen, but should have happened, in my opinion, on the Windrunner. A rare mistake from Goldart. He's usually a very solid support player, but I think he used the Frostbite too early. You want to save that Frostbite for when Windrunner uses her Windrunner ability, so you lock that down and she doesn't escape. Mm-hmm. The thing Freeza just did, he waited for all the slows and stuns to be used, and then he ran away freely. If they would have saved one of them, they would have got the kill.
Mm-hmm. Gonna give a lot of props to AL right now for as far as... it's something they've always done, but in the last couple of games we've watched of theirs, it does kind of lapse a little bit as far as warding goes. Now we've got sentries up in the middle lane. They're looking for that smoke gank to ensure that never happens to them. And then you've also got, like, there's an invis rune up on the top lane. I think that's the longest rune that has gone unattended for a long time because AL went down towards the bottom. You saw the rotation out from Darkseer looking for that bottom rune. They're just wanting to control the map, control the areas. And that's something which I feel was lacking in the last game from AL. But it just seems to be back a little bit more in this one. Musica getting initiated on. In fact, they are going to TP on this. Sprout will go after he's used his surge. He vacuums to get rid of the trees and gets himself back on the other line, other side of the line. And that's come with me TPing down for no kill.
That's very true. And these kills have to have... Oh, middle lane, by the way. Speaking of kills, that's going to be Leon falling. He does have his ultimate, though.
Stuns the wrong one.
Probably going to be... No, it's not even going to be popped there.
Surprising. Maybe it wasn't really for the kill. It doesn't really cost AL that much to do what they did.
That's very true.
To throw down a stun, they're forcing out the double stun. In fact, Skeleton kicked us through at the Hellfire Blast just because, like, you know what, I'm going to walk all the way back to base. There's time for him out of the lane.
That's very true, and they forced a TP coming in from Coco as well in that Enigma to try and help out as Dignitas got worried. Well, I also want to point out about that mid lane. Oh, Shaitan. Oh, he's going to be fine. His rage. The farming, as far as this lane goes, the Radiant have really helped out their mid lane with that Prophet. He's TP'd in twice, they've had Enigma ganking as well, and still, 21 for 6 on Leon Skeleton King, 42 for 16 on Shaitan's Lifestealer. He's got twice the farm, and he's the one who got ganked.
Mm. It does start to go the other way, though, when you look at CM, who's 0 for 1 and 0 for 2, as far as CS first and then kill count goes after that. So they're missing out on the other heroes. Like Snoopy's 10 for nil. If you look over the Dignitas side, sure, you go 3 for nil on the VS, but you got 35, 45, 57, 22 across their heroes. So Dignitas spreading up their farm a little bit more. And AL's got to be careful. If they put too much onto the nace, it might be too much. And now in towards the middle lane, it's initial stun going on. Lifesteal is losing a lot of life right now, but it's going to be enough. SK finishes the job. The Punch Hook bringing in Enigma, bringing it back. He's looking for a black hole. It's not going to come off. They're on the retreat back to the T1 tower. Snoopy lands up the shackle, but SK is there. He has no mana for his ultimate, so he's going to be really careful. Punch caught in a wall of trees.
Oh!
A wall of trees just shackles him there, and now using a shackle to a tree. He will go down as well. Godat finishes off the Vengeful Spirit, but now he's got three heroes on his tail, surrounded by trees, as well as enemy heroes. And Skeleton King gets himself another kill. Crystal Maiden goes down the middle.
Great individual detail there from Come With Me with those treants. As you pointed out, manages to surround Pudge with his treants so he can't get out of that beautiful, beautiful play. And great fight for Dignitas as well. They got the whole team and a tier 1 tower. And building their advantage is looking very good for them right now.
Yeah, that was impressive, impressive play to turn that around. And it was just a little bit of mispositioning, you got to say. Shaitan just a little bit too far down the river. But you knew why he wanted to do it. Like, it's mispositioning when you look at it with Captain Hindsight. But if you're looking at the start of it, it's like, we're looking to initiate. We're TPing heroes in for this. We want to take a fight. And then Dignitas were there. Dignitas had the best timing of their lives just then.
That's absolutely right. I'm not sure if they saw it coming or if they just had the same desire to fight. But they definitely got the better fight out of that.
Now we're gonna head towards bottom lane.
Hook, not gonna land.
Yeah, there was just no area for it. Even with the vacuum from music, it tried to set Windrunner up for it. Yeah, the hook already flew. This is troubling times for AL now. We see the gold advantage. Like, it had been sitting about 1,000 to the 7-minute mark, and now we're up to 5k gold advantage in favor of Dignitas. Wow, really? Did he just try and hook an Invis SK?
He was much closer than he thought. He saw him picking the Invis rune from the ward that they have down in the rune spot. And that was so close to landing, that would have been the hook of, well, maybe even the hook of the year if he would have landed that.
Now he's going to go again, and there goes the horde! Pulling back in range of the tier 2 tower will be enough damage. But that's why fortifications there. Blee's going to get himself out there. Tries to roam himself to death, but Enigma with the Malefus Vision's off the job. Shadow Shaman wards are down. Enigma pops off the black hole. Only captures Musica, but Musica will be enough. And it will be the kill on him. 3 heroes down for Rael while SK's having fun at the back end to play. Pudge is gone. Darcy is gone. Where's CM and Nakes? CM's already on the run, and Nakes is still free farming up in the top lane.
And this is looking more and more Dignitas with every minute that passes. They just keep finding good fights. Great hook from Bleak, but it's not the guy he wants to hook in. The whole plan for Dignitas was to get Skeleton King hooked. At least that's how it looked right then. Mm-hmm. Because obviously he has the second life from Reincarnation, and then that gives the team plenty of time to come in and assist. And they score 3 kills again. And almost a tier 2 tower here by the looks of it. Unless they might even get it. But it's a trade-off for a top then. Shatan is getting the job done up there. Trying to give AL some sort of a comeback here.
If there's one person to do it, Shatan could do it on Nakes. We've seen many, many times just how powerful Nakes is, and if we take this game later on, then really AL should have the advantage. They've got the push, they've got the tank ability, and the amount of damage which is going to be coming out from Dignitas, I don't think it's going to be enough if SK goes down. But that's a big if. That's a big if you can kill off an SK. His ultimate
and
makes him very
twice.
Powerful.
Yeah. He does have the 4 staff now. So that's going to make it even harder with that extra mobility he's got from that. But, and on the other hand, still no big farm on Leon. He's really not getting farmed. He has, however, been in 9 out of 12 kills, with 3 of them as a last hit. But he's still 32 CS. He's got ridiculously low CS on this hero. The carries on the Dire side have, like, twice the farm. Well, if you can call Pudge a carry, but Lifestealer at least. They're getting much more farm. However, Frieza and Coco kind of evening it out together with Come With Me on the Prophet.
Well, hello, top lane, Shackle, holding Supi as well as Shatan together. I don't know if they're actually thinking about that pretty strongly then. In fact, yes, they are. There's 5 heroes for AL on the top lane right now.
They're way too low. They're never going to get in. That Prophet ultimate just ripped them. And they don't have any healing.
Thank you.
They have an urn on Pudge, that's all. But that was the last charge he had. He's going to drop that on Snoopy to keep him on full HP now, but as far as all the others go, they're not looking too good. See him running all the way back to base for this.
I was going to point out before the little top engagement went off, the amount of farm that Nigma has got, because you were pointing out just how little Leon's got, but we're seeing 6...
Did you die? Okay, your headset died, man. At least the mic did. So I'm going to take over this while everything else is running. It's going to be another 2 kills for Dignitas here. They find Shadow Shaman as well as Pudge off guard up on top lane, getting those 2 kills, and are now trying to push the tier 1 tower. Meanwhile, Shatan's still on a farming spree down on the bottom lane, getting close to his armlet of Mordiggian now. And at the same time, Musica pushing out mid. So they're trying to get the best possible trade here, but the trades they're getting are just not worth it. Again, Dignitas getting more and more advantage now to 10k on the gold graph after 15 minutes. This is not a situation where you should see AL in, but Dignitas have really made it happen here with all their stuns and global presence of profit. And it looks like they're just trying to maximize their profits here by continuing up on the top lane with 4 heroes. Pushing on this tier 2 tower, and there's just nothing AL can do about it. They're going to have to sacrifice this one as well. That's a 14 for 3. It's a 5 tower advantage. And it's a dead Musica in the middle lane as well. Darkseer gets caught off. Blink Dagger on Enigma. Will now pick up an Invis rune as well. And is already looking towards the enemy woods here. Dignitas are never going to let AL come out of the base at this point. They've got so much control. Great stuns, great vision. Everything they need. And it's been a profit to cobble it up with, so they're looking very, very good at this point.
Yeah, controlling this map, I was talking about the wards control, but it doesn't help you when you got no tier 1s and no tier 2s, and now we're going to see Bleed being initiated on. Enigma is here for it. VS will start with his first stun. Enigma will chain off. Prophet's going to TP in as well. Can sprout if he needs to, but doesn't know that yes, he needs to until Snoopy comes in through the rear. So nice wall trap there on Come With Me, but he was expecting the mech and he was not expecting a VS swap coming out of that. Come With Me wants to go. Enigma comes in. The black hole only catching two of them, but it's enough time for Come With Me to go up towards the high ground, even though the Earths are coming in to help out with this little fight, even though the neutrals. Lifestealer almost gone, is gone. Still fighting within these wards, and that's why Windrun is popping up the Windrun so she can live a little bit longer so she can kill off Shaitan. Nice, kill off Snoopy, sorry. And then the power shot, not enough to finish off Crystal Maiden. Is he gonna dive this? Yeah, he's gonna dive this. Four staff up, he really wants this kill. And Frieza gets it too. Ballsy play, then TP's out. And an attempt to vacuum there from Musica is coming a little bit too late.
Yeah, this is just Dignitas playing their A game right now. They're getting everything together, everything lands. Perfect timing, good decisions throughout the entire game about where to go and when, mm-hmm. how to combo their spells. It's just, it's really one-sided, and it's unfortunate. It's not really what we want for a game like this, but it's the inevitable consequence of how things have just developed throughout the game, and now Dignitas, well, we kind of need a miracle to throw it. It's dangerous, we've said it before, and especially we had a game of Dignitas, they were totally dominating fire back then, and then they lost to a Darkseer. It could happen again.
It could. I really don't want to start talking about that possibility, because when that kind of stuff happens, I lose my voice, and it's already bad enough as it is. However, I think I'll be happy enough if it does happen, because then you guys get to enjoy the fun. Yeah, this is it's a dire position for AL. They've come back from worse. I've definitely seen them come back from worse. I've seen other teams do the same, but when you have, well, they've at least leveled out the gold graph. We hit 15k, and now it's flatlined. So maybe AL can find that opening. We have the armor up and lifestealer. He really needs to complete up phase boots or tread sometime bloody soon. But it's just so hard for him to do so. Especially when we see Dignitas forming up in the middle lane, and they're going to take care of the last tower outside the AL base. And because of this, it now means AL is forced back even further. They are forced to come back and TP back to defend, or at least try and hold it off while Shaitan gets some form of farm up.
Yeah, and Dignitas almost have twice the gold of AL. That's huge. They're going to have twice the gold of AL when they get Roshan. Almost. Almost anyway.
And we just saw a straight armlet for SK. Not even a prep for it, he just bought it.
Yeah. And that's just... I don't know, they have everything they need. They have the medallion on Vengeful for the extra minus armor. They've got 4 staff, soon Hex on Frieza, Mechanism, 4 staff on Prophet. They've got everything they need. The only thing they need to be careful of now on the Dignitas side is to not initiate a fight poorly.
Mm-hmm.
And it can happen. And if it happens against the Darkseer, you can lose it. You can be ahead by, I don't know how much you want, because all your gold is also gold for Darkseer in the fight. Because his illusions have a percentage-based damage based off you. So if you're stronger, he's stronger.
Yeah,
it's just how it is. That means, and Vacuum is just one of those great spells for making a comeback. If you drag them all together in a big bunch and you land a Crystal Nova on that, Ether Shock on that, and Pudge gets a good hook, you're on the...
Well, Shaitan, he's called out for starving Leon up. Come With Me is here. Shaitan's going to TP out in Rage. And they might be able to retreat out. In the meantime, Shadow Shaman gets called out by VS, as well as Windrun. Looks like he was shackled to a tree for a moment and trying to get himself surged away. Is the Pudge. The VS stun will land on Darcy, the man who was getting his Pudge away, and then a great hook, but then he gets shackled! Oh, he hooks, and then the shackle latches onto the Pudge! Could you be even any more unlucky? 4 star up from Frieza, chasing Godot inside the base. Even now, Anima comes up to join the fun, and Windrunner finishes the job with the power shot. Triple kill for Frieza.
Yeah, this Windrunner has pretty much been one of the big stories of this game. He's now 10-0-7. With 89 CS, he's just looking very, very good. And GG Re is now the call from Snoopy. They don't want to be in this anymore. They know there's nothing they can do at this point.
Yeah.
And very, very convincing play from Dignitas. I had not expected this to be this one-sided.
Yeah, it's... Well, AL, I was talking about at the very, very start. They've been having some troubles with form of late. Just knowing their focus, knowing where to go. And you can't really say that they lost this game themselves. You can still say Dignitas played well. Dignitas played very, very well in this game. Their timing was right, their decisions were right, their lanes worked right, and they got that initiation. Getting the first blood in CM was a small victory, but a big victory, and they're getting a second one, and then that big team fight around the tier 1 tower. things are just working for Dignitas. The question I'm going to have, Sind, is will it work for them in game two? That's why we have best of threes.
It definitely is, and well, if we want to go that down that path, then Dignitas are going to be even more better off in the second game as far as hosting goes, because now we're going on US East, and that's closer to them, so they're going to be, in that sense, going to be stronger on that, but you can't call out anything on that, but it's just something to note that it's not going to be harder for them. Let's put it that way. The host switch is not going to be a disadvantage for Dignitas.
All right, we're going to be back in a couple of moments, guys. Game number two coming up, Dignitas versus Absolute Legends. The stream will go down for just a moment. Do not panic. Things will be okay for you. We'll be back here in just a couple of moments' time.
I said good day, sir!